The 757-200 operates very few long-haul flights nowadays, where we would define long-haul as any route being 3,000 miles or 4,828 kilometers or more. Analysis of Cirium data shows that this 757 variant had just 79 long-haul services across 13 routes between November 21st and 27th. To put it into context, the 737 MAX 8, MAX 9 and A321neo, much more fuel-efficient types, had over 700 flights and more than 65 routes. Let's examine these lengthy 757 services in today's video. Looking at the recent flight schedule data, the 79 flights involved just three carriers: United with 50, Iceland Air with 17, and Russia's Azure Air with 12. While Delta had some last winter and summer, it's no longer the case. And at the time of producing this video, Delta has none scheduled for the future. Some 15 airports in 7 countries had long-haul 757-200 flights during the last full week of November. Denver had the most, with 20, followed by Newark with 11. Indeed, 60% of services are to or from the US, no surprise at all given the airlines operating the type. A comparison with the equivalent week in 2019 is insightful. At that time, the 757-200 had 202 long-haul flights involving 7 airlines, 41 airports and 15 countries. United was still the number one carrier and the US was the top country. 757 has had quite a fall, both because of a shift to much more economical equipment and because of coronavirus-driven equipment withdrawals. Organized by distance, here are the long-haul routes operated by the 757-200 in late November. The longest 757 route this week is between Keflavik in Iceland and Portland, Oregon, with a length of 3,738 miles or 6,016 kilometers. The flight has a duration of 8 hours going from Keflavik to Portland and 7.5 hours in the eastbound direction. It's actually served 4 times weekly, but the 757-200 is only used on half of those flights, with the rest utilizing the Boeing 737 MAX 8. Iceland's flag carrier also operates the 3rd and 4th longest 757 routes, with service to Denver and Orlando. The 2nd longest has United Airlines flying 4 times a week between Newark Liberty Airport in New Jersey and Lima, Peru. The distance of this particular route is 3,631 miles or 5,844 kilometers. In addition to this South American route, United takes its Boeing narrowbodies partway across the Pacific to Lihue and Kona from its Denver hub, and also flies transatlantic from Newark to Edinburgh. Interestingly, Russia's Azure Air fills out most of the remainder of the list, with international services out of Russia to countries like India and Thailand. What is the longest 757 flight you've been on? And which of the airlines mentioned would you prefer to fly with using a Boeing 757? Let us know in the comments. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.